All right, today we're covering one of my favorite topics, and that is how to recover photos, messages, and contacts from your iPhone. And by the way, if you get any value out of this video at all, be sure to leave me a like and comment down below and letting me know. All right, let's get started. So jumping right in here, what a lot of people don't know is that there's actually a decent amount of safeguard functionality built right into iOS that's built for situations just like this that you can utilize without even having to touch your Mac or any kind of third-party software at all. So starting right off the bat with deleted photos, you can check the album in your camera roll literally titled Recently Deleted. So just go ahead and open up your Photos app on your iPhone and scroll all the way down and hit Recently Deleted. And here you'll see all the photos and videos that have been deleted in the last 40 days. Select the photos or videos you want to recover, and tap Recover to restore them all to your camera roll. Next up is messages. How do you recover those that have been recently deleted? Well, it's a similar story there. There's actually a folder for recently deleted iMessages as well that you can easily access the same way you did the Photos app. Just a little bit different. So just go into your iMessage app, then hit Edit in the top left, then hit Show Recently Deleted, and you can then browse the list of deleted messages and select the ones you want to recover. So when it comes to contacts, it's not quite as straightforward. iCloud definitely does keep a backup of all of your contact data in the cloud just in case you ever need it, but that of course is predicated upon the fact that you actually use iCloud in the first place. iCloud is provided for most versions of iOS these days. However, if you disabled your iCloud for some reason or you decide not to pay for it, then there's a bit of a lapse in functionality there. But for most people, this will still be applicable, and really all you need to do to ensure that your iPhone was enabled for iCloud is to go to Settings, click your Apple ID, iCloud, Show All, and make sure the switch next to Contacts is checked. Then all you have to do to sync the two and restore the contact that was deleted, simply uncheck the box, select Keep on my iPhone, then recheck the box, and hit Merge. Okay, yeah, Andrew, that's great, but what about after the 40 days? This was months ago, or something else happened, like I accidentally wiped my phone, or something crazy like that. Something out of the ordinary that requires a little more heavy lifting. Well, at this point, you're gonna need to rely on a pretty robust piece of file recovery software. And the one I recommend for situations just like this is called Disk Drill, and it's gonna be our weapon of choice for this case scenario. When it comes to iPhone data recovery, Disk Drill really shines. Not only does it enable recovery of photos, messages, and contacts, but with Disk Drill 5, virtually anything can be recovered from an iPhone, from files and archives, presentations, messages from Skype, Kick, WhatsApp, and more. However, as powerful as Disk Drill is, ensuring your success is really predicated upon stopping use of your iPhone as soon as you possibly can. What this will do is it will aid in preventing the files from being further overwritten, which will allow us a much better file recovery chance in the long run. Files are easily recovered if they are intact and not overwritten on a device, and getting this done as soon as possible will give you the best chance of positive results. Finally, the really good news here is that Disk Drill 5 allows you to scan and view your files for free prior to upgrading to the Pro version. It gives you all the power and flexibility you need right at your fingertips, and it can be downloaded from the description below. All right, let's get started. So first of all, go ahead and download and install Disk Drill to your Mac. Next, go ahead and connect your iPhone to your Mac, and if prompted on your iPhone, hit Trust. Next, launch Disk Drill, and you'll be brought to the data recovery panel and the disk list, a list of all the available drives and devices currently connected to your Mac. Next, select your iPhone from the list and hit search for lost data to start the scan of your phone. So at this point, we just need to wait for the scan to complete. So once it's done, we'll pick up from there. And once the scan is finished, you can preview the files by category in the center. And as I said before, previewing them is the best way to ensure that a file, like a photo in this case, has a good shot of being recovered in full. It's a really valuable way to actually see what's recoverable and what's not, to really get an idea of how much you're actually looking at when it comes to a file recovery from your iPhone. Now, to recover your data, it's actually pretty straightforward. Just select the category that you want, then find the file or files that you need, select them, hit Recover, and save them to your preferred location. This process is the same for photos, contacts, messages, and anything else that you need to get from your iPhone. The process is universal, and once you save them to your preferred location, they're available to be transferred or viewed any way you like. And that's it. It's really as easy as that. That is how you recover photos, messages, and contacts from your iPhone using a couple different methods. And I hope that this video really helped you guys and you got some good out of it. If you did, always be sure to leave us a like down below. Also, if you have any questions, comments, concerns at all about this video, or a topic that you want me to cover in a future video, just be sure to let me know down below in the comments. But that is going to be it for this video. My name is Andrew. Until next time, thank you for watching.